if you want, as long as your hips are forward. Here we go. Starting now. Bring it up. Foot is flexed. You really want to feel it working. We're just starting. You want to feel it working through this muscle. Keep going. Remember to bring your hips forward. Do not want to be. You know, we like this because it feels so good, but it does nothing. That's right, nothing. As you lift and lower. And lift. It's amazing how these muscles, these little muscles, feeling fibers, right? Ugh. Two more. This is a one. And two. Now bring that leg slightly forward. It's your platform. And go. Now the leg up and down. And lift. And lift. Well, the other day I was telling you about probably, you know, when you're a child, you're more sensitive and more embarrassed than you ever will be. You know, there's always humiliation to look forward to later on in life, but real embarrassment. And I explained two more. This is one and two. Now, both legs in a little bit more. Now bring the knee in and out. And out. Out. So the knee comes in towards the chest, out. And I explained how I was invited to the most popular boys' birthday party when I was in the sixth grade, one of 14, chosen, leaving the gift, you know, to say purchase to my mother who wrapped it up. Everybody giving him records, alpaca socks, two more. This is one and two. Now, make sure your legs are 90 degrees. Knees are lined up, feet as you lift and lower. Knee to knee. So when he gets to my gift, he opens it up and it's a Lone Ranger plastic yellow gun with a red light that goes knee. Now, I was saying that kids in the sixth grade have no sense of humor. Obviously, you know, when a young boy turns 11 or 12, you know, 7 or 6, he's too close. You got to pretend it's horrible. And then, of course, I was a reject. That's from the time that everybody discovered that my, oops, two more, oh, one, and two. Now, as you go over, elbows are slightly bent, and you just brush the knee out and back. You don't bring it up much higher than a brush. You keep the back extended, head slightly looking out. And I think that was the time also that my mother dressed me. I should have learned. You know, the gift should have been enough. But, you know, put me things like red polka dot skirts with cinch belts with rock and roll here to stay, you know, she's a and striped blouses. You know, up until that point, nobody really noticed I didn't dress well. But then, of course, once you're an outcast, and everybody just thinks, oh, my goodness. And you, can you imagine walking into the hall two more? This is 01 and 2. Extend the leg. Now lift. And everybody whispering. You gave someone a Lone Ranger gun. And then they decide you don't know how to dress either. My only salvation was that it was May. In June, we had vacation for 3 months. I begged my mother to move. And if she wouldn't move, could I at least change schools? And if she wouldn't do that, could she please do something, you know, like shave my head or something, disguise me, change my name? But by the end of summer, of course, you know, you go to your junior high and they forget. Keep going. One and two. Now stretch it back. All the way back. Release the back. We love this position. The squirrel. We love squirrels. All right. Other side. Time for the other leg. All right. Bottom leg is here as you lift and lower. Decide what position that you want to use is best for you. Outer side. Pulling into the abdominals. Hip is forward. As you get better at these exercises, you can also add ankle weight. But do you ever notice how when you're younger, I mean, it's so embarrassing to you that you really do want to move. You really do want to change schools. All right, bring the bottom leg up. So terrible. Bad haircuts are real bad when you're, you know, you're about 12 or 13. Keep going. It's a lift. And lift. And there was a time that they used to have these like macrame looking necklaces that were great, but they were real expensive, you know, and you get 50 cents a week allowance, you know, you gotta save a lot of money. So my girlfriend and I dyed Kraft macaroni, red and blue. You know, this is true, but everybody does stupid. Last one. Now bring the knees in and flex. And strung them, right? Wore them like, oh yes, we have the very latest macrame looking beads. And I mean, it looked really good. The only problem was, because you dyed them, that as soon as the sun came out, your macaroni started to wilt and the dye was all over our blouse. And when the word got, I mean, can you imagine? I finally got out of the summer, you know, by getting, you know, people finally forgot that I didn't dress that well and that I gave somebody a cap gun. Keep going. It's a one more. Now the legs together, 90-degree angle. It's a lift and lower. Take your time. It's sweet. So I finally get over that, and what do? I wait 1 year, and then I dye macaroni, and that gets all over me, and I lie to my girlfriend, and they see we're wearing Kraft macaroni, and you're like 13 years old. Do you understand what a nerd is?
Well, Now we do.
I mean, what a dip. So again, I had to go home and ask my mother to move. She wouldn't move. All right, again. She got tired of moving, you know what I mean? It's a lift. And lift. Bend the elbows. And elbows. And then she, of course, said, I told you that was a stupid idea. I said, yeah, you should have stopped me. She says, no, it's good to learn from your mistakes. I mean, that meant no boyfriends again for about 3 years. And going around, geez, you know, remember her? She was the one that used to wear the rock and roll blouse with the polka dots and stripes and gave blank, who remained nameless, a cap gun. It's great. Oh, keep going. That's why I went into exercise. Last time. A lift. Because that's what all the unpopular kids did that time. They either went into PE or ROTC. Keep going. Lift. And lift. So it's in the back of the leg. It's right behind the gluteus as you lift. Foot is flexed and down. Extend. And extend. You want to put it to the back of the thigh. Again, if you can also put the head down if it's too hard in the lower back. As you lift and lower. Keep going. 5, 6, 7, 8. Now all the way down. And bring it in and out. We're not going to extend them all the way because we're going to squeeze. We're working on the back of the hamstrings. Try doing 20 more of these. Put on those aerobic shoes and be right back with aerobics. Now, a lunge of right and left. Do the right and left. Now, elbow to the knee. Back is flat. Take it up. Now, press it out. And take it right and left. 5 and 6. Now, reach it up again. Take it left. Well, you know how we're always saying you should stay in shape? Well, in China, this is true now. I don't lie here, though. Bring it up. To the right. Take it. Now, just right and left this time. In China, if you want to get some of the new housing, for example, they had some, is it Beijing, how you say it?
Beijing.
They had some new houses up. And what they do is they raise. That's right. And the winner that gets to the house first gets the house. Can you imagine? So some of the Chinese, they hire professional runners. Okay, out of my way. Could you imagine there's a new development here in Westlake? Run to your house.
There's an angel in it.
You know, don't you see it? Exactly what I thought, Mr. Wally.
Run to your house.
Hey, do you understand? This house, you know, they used to have Dream House. 6, 7, and 8. They said, I don't even know if that show's still on, but I mean, you know, you sort of answered some questions, and you'd get a key, other stuff, and then, you know, you'd open the door and it got, which meant you didn't win the house. But this one, there's always a winner. You know, even if the houses are made out of fiberglass, who cares?
I'd hire the roadrunner.
Yeah, right. And you'd hit over the head. No, but I think there is a new show in that. Run for your house! And have room groups and all that, different running races there. Keep twisting now. And double time. And right. And left. Now bring it down. Back is flat. Keep going. All right. And left. Can you see yourself? Instead of worrying about the mortgage, you've got to say, okay, dear, come on now. You've got to be jogging those laps. Get in shape. You need that house. Now 7 and 8. Now take it 1. We'll just keep going. Now other side. Now clap and bring it over. Take it 5, 6, 7. Now with a clap before. 1, 2, 3. Up. A 3. Way up. We like to do these little clappy things in the morning. It wakes you up. Yeah, we like it. Echoes up the palm trees. 2, 3, way up. Bring that shoulder in. Okay, now lunge. We're going to come back with some great, by your special request, inner thigh exercise. All right, keep going. Is there anything that really aggravates you more than when you put on that bathing suit for the first time and you see this slack, right? That's not mine. Yeah. Well, it is yours. And you have to do specific exercises to keep it in shape. You'll find even athletes, you know, they're always doing some sort of exercise, whether it's something that they do because they're sprinters or whatever, to keep this in shape. So for inner thigh slack, which starts, and I'd say after the age of 18, that's right, you've got some years ahead. All right. These are the good to exercise, and if you want to add more resistance to this, you would put on some wrist weights. But what are you waiting for? These are something they can even do if they're in bed, right, folks? Right. Mr. Bill is back here from his trip inside and outside again to time us, and we're going to start with the hands beneath the lower back. Come on, now you can do these right in your bed, see? And your legs are here, and we're just going to go out. Here we go. So it goes out and in. Out, in. Now you want to flex the feet. You want to be able to feel those inner thighs and feel that they're nice and taut. That's the right word? Taut.
Taut.
Taut. What is it?
Taut.
Taut. Taut. All right. So the legs are over the hips. Your best.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Very nice.
See, this is a good group exercise. Give me the old shoe right in the middle. Move. So it's out and in. Now the feet are flexed. Try and have straight legs if you can. You can't do this exercise without bending your knees slightly. That's okay, too. Inner thighs. Now, a lot of you write to me and you say, Joanie, there is a disaster occurring. When I put on my shorts, what happens is a stiff wind gets my inner thighs flopping. I hear you. It is a part that really can get ugly. You got to tell yourself, okay, I'll add this to my exercise repertoire. Two more. This is one and two. All right, now you're going to out there and bounce. Bounce slow. Hello. You feel that? I want to hear some exuberance here.
Right.
Oh! Oh! Now, men don't seem to have as much of a problem with it as women. I mean, what else is new, right? Because we seem to have more fat in this part of our anatomy, just naturally. When God gave out fat, he said, you will have children so you get more fat in your thighs and hips. But because of that ugliness, you also get to live up to 8 to 9 years longer without those men to taunt you, see? So it's all right. You with your very taut inner thighs, you live longer. But anyway, we can have those nice inner thighs too. But man, this doesn't mean that you still should do these exercises. It just all goes down. Keep going. And anytime you get tired doing these kind of exercises, just simply bring your knees in. We have our exercises continue. Oh, here we go. It's one and two. Now this time, your legs are up here. You go one, two, three, two, together. So it's one, two, three, two, together. Now try and keep your legs nice and, in other words, you create your own resistance on it. One, two, three, two, together. So the more you can flex your feet on this, more that you will really feel. You notice that if you keep your legs nice and stiff, the more you will feel this on the inner thigh. So it's out. True, yes. And of course, right now we have Joy and Vicky very silent back there, which means that means on the level of suffering of 10. I love it when we wear these ankle weights. I mean, there's some days you just can't pull those legs back up. Oh my goodness, it's Miami Vice. They're coming. All right, I think you're living, John Johnson. Do you think so? Last time. All right, now it's cross. Point your toes this time. It's out. Cross. Out. Cross. Think of leading with your inner thighs, hands are behind the lower back. Back is flat. You should not arch your back when doing this. If you find that your back is arching, probably for you, you should bend your knees slightly. It's a little too stressful for you to have straight legs. More important, the back is down. And breathe. So it's... All right. And you breathe. Now, let's say you say, right now, I can't stand any longer, Joanie. I need to rest. What do? And don't roll over. We have our exercises. Exercises continue. Blood's going to my, I don't know where, my feet. Just bring your knees in for a minute. What you would do is you just sort of rotate them like this, forward and back. Oh, that feels good. I like that. Oh, sorry, guys. And then come back strong. That way, too, you release your back. Two more. This is one and two. Now, this time you bring them in, out, together, and out. Extend. Extend. Again, so really bend. Try and get those heels to aim towards your gluteals. Heels.
This is brutal.
You like? I know, Mr. Wally, I know it's hard to direct and do things in there in that small booth.
I can't move anymore.
Oh, well, please, your toe is hooked onto the microphone in there, I see. I actually did it to Mr. Wally because he did put on his Bermuda the other day, and, you know, the man was a wreck. I mean, he just couldn't go out by the pool. I said, what's wrong? He said, don't tell anyone, Joanie. He said, my inner side. He says, I guess it's been all these years of just, you know, being in the chair, yelling at people. This is what's happened to me. So I said, we'll do something for you. Everybody's made room for him inside. There he is. Little tiny legs. So it's in, out, together. Come on, you can do it. Remember, you have the power to change those sides. Last time. All right, now this time, bring them together. Point the toes out, flex them in. The toes and heels. Toes, heels. Also a very good, remember we have vacation exercises. There you are at the beach. No one is looking at you. You just do your inner thigh exercises like this. A whole crowd comes around because they know, you know the secret to staying in shape. Out and in. Keep going and again. Remember, if you add ankle weights to these exercises, it's even more effective after you sort of attain a certain degree of fitness. The first one is to get over this hurdle. It's out and in again. Keep breathing. Of course, you know, when we come back and do aerobics, you'll probably say, but I can't walk. I can't get up. I'll do my aerobics now. Thank you. Again, it's out. All right, continue through the break. Put on those aerobic shoes. We'll be right back with aerobics. You can stand. Don't worry. Thank you.
has been provided by the following companies.
Plan your summer vacation around health, fitness, and beauty at Safety Harbor Spawn Fitness Center. Now only $95 to $93 a day, including meals and massages. A fabulous vacation alternative close to home. Call 1-800-237-0155.
Ready? I win lots of races, Rosie.
Okay, go.
In the race to grab spills, Bounty's quicker than any other ordinary towel.
Bounty won.
In record time, it's a quicker picker-upper.
Purell Moisturizing Lotion.
Most women agree. Purell ends dry skin.
Do you know how to help a choking victim? Get a pull-out toaster of the Heimlich Maneuver in the new issue of Family Circle. It could save a life.
Always wear aerobic shoes during your workout.